It is time now for the Rhody Roundup. We are chatting about some of the headlines making the rounds this week. So let's say good morning to our panel. Scarpetti from 94HJY, our friend Bronwyn is back from WaterFire, and another local reality TV alum, Louie Stravato. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
All right, let's jump right in. I love this story. A dad recently made headlines for a Facebook post about trying to be mom for a day. This was while his wife was away, you know, getting some treatment done at the hospital. She was fine. He wrote that he failed after only 16 hours, explaining in part, "I have not even mastered the ability to keep my own personal hygiene as a mom, let alone the ability to keep a house, educate children, prepare meals, and even venture outside for activities." There's something to be said about a busy parent, right?
Absolutely.
I'll tell you what, me and Scott Petty were talking about it earlier. I did this. I don't know what he's thinking. He's doing, he like created something. I mean, we've done this. I've become the mom several times.
Yeah, I got a 2-year-old home right now.
I raised my kids from 10 and 3, you know?
But it's gonna be overwhelming.
It is.
It is,
but I mean, you can do it. I mean, this is 2016,
mm-hmm.
you know?
Absolutely.
It's not,
yeah.
You know, back in the day.
I have trouble taking care of my Weimaraners, so I'm really sorry. I can't speak to it that well.
It is hard. No matter what parent is picking up the brunt of the whole thing, it's hard. But nowadays, mostly everyone's 50-50. Me and my wife's 50-50.
Yeah.
It is extremely tough. You know, in the Avengers movie, the Hulk says he's always angry. I always said when I was a first parent that I was always tired. I was just like that. Always, always tired. And that's the way it is nowadays. But it's funny. We were talking about how on TV, a lot of the sitcoms, the dad is always the bumbling idiot while the wife knows everything. But that's not true in real life. All of us dads,
most
of
them.
No. I'm chasing dirty diapers like there's no tomorrow.
But it's getting easier with a second child?
I don't have a second yet. I'm gonna get the one.
I have two boys.
Louis got two.
I have two boys, and it's I did it all.
Okay.
I did everything.
Oh,
I'm not patting myself on the back, but I did it.
No, but I'll pat you.
All right, thank you.
Let's move right along now. A dream situation for a lot of people when it started raining money in Providence on Wednesday. This was after three bags of cash fell off a Brinks truck and they just kind of went flying everywhere. Have you ever found money and what did you do in that situation? Because I feel like you hear these stories a lot. You know, someone finds this big envelope and it's full of a lot of cash and you kind of, you know, you want to keep it, but there's that guilt. What would you do in this situation?
The most I've ever found was $100. I mean, I looked around. That's a lot of money, you know? But in a situation like that, the cop comes out at me, the retired police officer. Cameras are everywhere, all right? Cameras are everywhere, and you can't, you're like, you know, if you take that money that was blown off that truck, that's stealing. Mm-hmm. So, you know,
right,
I mean, as much as you want to grab it, as much as you want to grab it.
I would have been there with a net going, thanks, WaterFire.
Donations.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah, there you go. That's not a bad idea.
What if you didn't notice from the truck, though? All of a sudden, you just started seeing this money raining.
I think
down.
Louis, it depends where you are, you know, or with the situation you're in.
Yeah.
I would look around, make sure that no one's around looking for the money, you know. One time I found it at the bottom of a pool, like $20. You know,
who was swimming with cash in
I don't know. I was like, what's going on here? But it was nice, and I came up, I looked around, no one was around, so.
Hey, when I find change on the ground, it's like, I'm being paid to walk.
Yeah, there you go.
You were getting paid to swim, right?
Not a bad
there
day at the pool, you know?
All right, last but not least, another story that's been making a lot of rounds is Taylor Swift and her new love interest, Tom Hiddleston. Now, you might know him. He was in Thor.
Yes.
He's been in a lot of movies. He's rumored to possibly be the next James Bond, but she's been spotted getting pretty up close, getting real cozy with him shortly after ending a relationship. Do you like keeping up with this?
It's all you hear, Michaela.
Yeah.
It's all you hear.
Like
Calvin Harris was the big thing for what? How about like 16 months? Mm-hmm. Something like that, whatever it was.
Oh, you got it down to the month.
Oh, you know, I got it down to the month. I'm a Swiftie, whatever you want to call it. But, I mean, she's from Rhode Island, so we got to follow it.
Yeah.
Right? In a sense, you know? But who cares? I'm sorry. Hashtag. I'm like, who cares?
She is young, though.
Yeah.
I mean, should she really be getting a lot of flack for this? I mean, she ended a relationship and now she's smooching another guy, but
who cares?
Yeah.
Really?
She's human.
Yeah, that's
she's human.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's an adult, right?
Yeah.
Is it wrong that I'm more jealous of her than him, though?
Okay.
he's awesome. I'm a big comic.
Yeah, he's very cool. Yeah.
I love all those movies, and I'm like, man, he's a really good
he
actor.
He plays a really good bat.
He's not bad looking. I'm comfortable with myself saying that. And, you know, I'm a little jealous. I'm a little jealous. Maybe I might go down to Westerly and stalk the two of them.
There you go. You might be smooching with Thomas Kennedy just a little bit.
The policeman's going to
I know what beach they're at. Let's go.
Thank you guys so much for joining us today. Always great catching up with our Rhody Roundup panel.